This meeting, today concept name is selenium.
Okay.
Today concept name is selenium. What is selenium? Selenium is nothing but selenium. Today concept name is selenium. What is selenium? Selenium is nothing but it is a software. Selenium is nothing but it is a software which contains some set of programs which contains some set of programs. Today concept is Selenium web driver.
Okay.
Today concept name is Selenium web driver. Today class is very important. After this class, you can work with any application without my support, without Google support, without any support, you can work with any application. So Selenium WebDriver. What is Selenium WebDriver? Selenium WebDriver is nothing but same definition. Selenium WebDriver is nothing but it is a software which contains some set of programs. This set of programs we need to configure or we need to install into one user interface. We need to install into one user interface.
Okay.
In the place of user interface, we are using Eclipse. We are using Eclipse. We are using Eclipse. What is Eclipse? Eclipse is nothing but it is a powerful editor to write the Java programs. That means this Selenium WebDriver programs. This Selenium WebDriver programs we need to install into Eclipse. That is the concept. Today, first concept, how to configure Selenium WebDriver programs into Eclipse. How to configure Selenium WebDriver programs into Eclipse. So the first concept, how to configure Selenium WebDriver programs into Eclipse. So
okay.
Just steps. Just go to right click on project.
Okay.
Right click on project.
Right click on.
Go to properties. Java build path. Libraries. Add external jars. Choose jars. Click on OK. Right click on project, properties, Java build path, libraries, add external jars, choose jars, click on OK. How to configure Selenium WebDriver programs into Eclipse? Already I have downloaded Selenium WebDriver programs. Already I have downloaded Selenium WebDriver programs. This Selenium WebDriver programs we need to configure into Eclipse. Even after this class, before class I am telling. So after this class, even fourth class kid, you don't know anything, still you can learn Selenium. So easily you can learn Selenium, but practice required. So just I will tell you after class, you can tell me. So even fourth class kid also you can learn Selenium. Without knowing Java also you can learn Selenium. Without knowing anything, ABCD also you can learn Selenium. It's that much of easy. Just practice required. Okay. I will after class you can tell me. Right, first go to Eclipse.
Okay, yeah, I mean, yeah,
already I have Selenium WebDriver programs already downloaded 2.21. I have different versions, but right now I am installing 2.21 old WebDriver programs.
Okay, did I need to download it or I can download that later?
Already have downloaded. I have no need to download yourself. So I will send you latest version as new version. Both I will send you.
Okay.
Right. Go to Eclipse. Project Explorer. Take the new project.
Okay, create a new project. Okay.
Take new project. Project name
Java
is
project.
Java project. Click on next. Project name is Peter. Click on finish. After creating the project, we need to configure Selenium WebDriver programs. Right click on project, go to properties, Java build path, libraries, add external jars. I'm choosing the jars, control all, click on open, click on OK. Already I configured. So this is not Eclipse. This is the Selenium WebDriver now. Go to SRC. Normally you can take the new class. Class name is WD1. Hit the mark publish start void menu, click on finish. We learned one line from Java. What is that line? Interface name, reference name equal to interface name, reference name equal to new class name.
Yeah.
Interface name, reference name equal to new class name. Interface name, reference name equal to new class name. Here interface is WebDriver. WebDriver, WebDriver. Here is interface is WebDriver. Reference name WD equal to new Firefox driver. Class name is Firefox driver I am taking. Interface name, reference name equal to new class name. So WebDriver is a interface. WebDriver.
Okay.
WebDriver, what you open QU Selenium. Just we need to import the statements. Why? Because it is a predefined class. WebDriver is a predefined class. Change to WebDriver, third one. WebDriver, what you open QA Selenium. Right.
Okay.
Firefox driver, third one. Change to Firefox driver. If you want to work with any site, just we should write wd.get. If you want to work with any site name, that name should we should write http dot. If you want to work with Gmail, we can write Gmail or gmail.com. It will open the Gmail page. It will open the Gmail page now. It will open the Gmail page now. It will
okay.
open the Gmail page now. Save. Save. Click on run. It will open the Gmail page. If you want YouTube, it will open the YouTube page. If you want Google, it will open the Google page. So here there is nothing required without knowing anything. Gmail page open. If you want to work with Google, then just you should write Google. Google. It will open the Google page. It will open the Google page. Google.com. Save. Click on run. HTTP Google page, google.com. It will open the Google page. Like, right. If you want to work with Facebook, then we should write facebook.com. Facebook.com.
Okay. If you want. But do we not need? Okay, okay.
Facebook.com. Save.
But how does it know which browser?
I'm taking Firefox browser. If you want, I will teach you a different browser. So, but today we want to work with the Firefox browser.
Okay, okay.
If you want to work with any other browsers, I will tell you how to work with other browsers also. I will tell you.
Okay, no, that's fine. That's fine.
Okay, right.
Okay.
So each and every web, so I entered into Facebook. I entered into Facebook. I need to enter username. I need to enter password. I need to click on sign in button or login button. These are called web elements. These are called web elements. Each and every web element having one unique location, that is called XPath. Each and every web element having one unique location, that is called XPath. We need to find out the unique location. What is XPath? It is a unique location of the web element. Unique location of the web element, unique location of the web element.
Okay.
Right. It is a unique location of the web element. If we want to find out the unique location, compulsory we should have fire path. We should have fire path. What is fire path? Compulsory, if you want to find out the XPath, compulsory we should have fire path. It is a add-on of Firefox. It is the add-on of Firefox, which is used for finding the XPath of the web element. We need to download Firepath. Okay, element. Right. Where we can get Firepath? We have in Firebug. What is Firebug? It is also add-on of Firefox. It is also add-on of Firefox, which is used for inspecting the web element.
Okay.
Inspecting the web element.
So every item which is we can interact with is a web element.
Yes. So Firebug and Firepath both compulsory we need. Okay. Why? Because each and every web element, if it is list to box, edit box, select box, combo box, radio button and select button or whatever it is. So these are the web elements. Each and every web element having one unique location. We need to find out that unique location. That is called XPath. How we can get XPath? Firebug and Firepath. Firebug and Firepath. So what is Firepath? It is a add-on of Firefox, which is used for finding the XPath of the web element. Where we can get the Firepath? We have in Firebug. So
okay.
We need to download Firebug and Firepath. How to download Firebug and Firepath? Download. Just go to Google.
Yeah.
Download Firebug. First, we need to download Firebug. I am using old version of Mozilla Firefox. Why I am using, I will tell you later. So I am using Mozilla Firefox old version. Download Firebug. Just click on the link, second link. We can get options. Just click on an older version.
Okay. Correct.
Click on 1.9. Click on 1.9.0.
Okay, for Firebug, older version, okay.
Click on allow. So it will take only 1 minute. Within 1 minute, it will install Firebug.
1.90.
1.9.0. Click on install now. Restart now. So installed. So no need of that one. Right. Next, we need to download Firepath. Just write Firepath. Click on enter. Add to Firefox. First link, click on it. Just click on add to Firefox. Click on allow. Install now. Restart now. Now I want to work with the Facebook application. So
okay.
We need to find out the each and every web element XPath. First we should write wd dot. Just keep the F, find element option will come, find element by dot
okay.
XPath will come. I'm giving the XPath dot send keys. Options will come. No need to write manually. Akil ready. HYD 1, HYD 1.
Okay.
Control V, Control V. Dot click.
Okay. So send keys, I assume means type.
Venkarna 143. So that is the button. We need to enter username and password. We need to click on button. So
yeah.
First we need to find out the username. Go to Gmail page. Gmail page. Sorry, not Gmail. Facebook. First we need to enter username. So this is the Firebug and Firepath. Firebug and Firepath installed or not, how we know? Just go to tool, sorry, Firefox, web developer, Firebug. Okay, Firebug will come. This is the activator. Each and every time we need to activate. If you want to hide the Firebug, we can use this option. And Firepath, this one, XPath we can get here. If you want get the XPath, each and every time we should activate. We should activate. Just activate. Username XPath. XPath is something it is showing. Copy. Control V. Right, I got the XPath.
Okay.
Next, I want to get password XPath. Once again, activate. Go to password field, click on that. You can get the password field. Password XPath.
Yeah.
Copy. Control V. I need to click on sign in button. So get the sign in button XPath. Copy. Control V. Enough. Now it will go to Facebook. It will enter username. It will enter password. It will click on sign in button. So here is nothing required. Here is nothing required. Without knowing Java, without knowing anything, we can learn this Selenium very comfortably. Already I told you, even fourth class kid also you can learn Selenium. But practice required. Save. Click on run. Right. Okay. That is the concept
yeah.
of Selenium. First concept. After this class, if you want to work with any application, you should know only one thing. So there are different web elements in the application. So first one, text box. Text box means username and password. Text box.
Yeah.
Text box means username and password. Both are text boxes and text box one is next select box. First one is select box, second one is text box. Only for this concepts we will use send keys. We will use option is send keys.
Okay, so anytime you put a write anything.
Next button link image, radio button, checkbox. We will use click button, link, image, radio box, and checkbox. We will use click. We will use click. This is the concept. After this class, you can work with any web application comfortably without knowing anything, without having any my support or Google support, without any support, directly you can work with any application. That is the concept. Selenium. That is the concept, Selenium. So
okay.
Over.
And is it always